We believe there is a lot of exploitation in the services industry, and when we created Sahaj, we thought that is one thing that we can certainly challenge. And when we talk about reducing exploitation, we talk about doing it across the board, not only with our people, but with our client networks, with our supplier networks, with anybody that we interact with. We believe in our people, we trust our people, and that and their capabilities, and that brings in the level of solutioning that we get out there today.
The way service industry needs to operate is actually contrary to what is happening. So we wanted to get together and prove that there is a better way of doing IT services, creating small teams, creating simple solutions, and not having long-term contracts, but actually doing things which are simple and which can be handed over a lot more easily.
I work as a dev here, but I'm not just a developer. I am a CEO. We're all CEOs here. We work on aspects that touch every facet of the company, and your ability to take up something, tackle it, and take it to completion. And I think this brings out the individuality to the fore and also nurtures your entrepreneurial spirit.
Be it a decision like a profit share on deciding a director salary or taking up this new office space and everything. So we don't have any hierarchical model here in this company, and that lets you a free hand to decide on the decision that needs to be taken.
We human beings deliver our best when we are by ourselves. We at Sahaj extend the same by not retrofitting people into policies, processes, or a belief system, but bound by the values, transparency, trust, integrity, ownership, and partnership.
So working as Sahaj is like running your own startup without the stress of it. When we are building solutions for our customer, we are considering all the aspects and not just the technology delivery.
So at Sahaj, we don't really believe in tying down people and suppressing their creativities with giving them defined roles. So we have lots of opportunities where people can grow, learn, and contribute. So we are always providing simple yet powerful solutions for our clients.
The whole industry is actually moving towards avoiding the mid-level managers. We actually did that 3 years back. So we never had a mid-level managers. We went even further. We don't even have a business analyst. We don't even have a quality analyst. Everything is actually done by the same individual developers so that he feels complete satisfaction of his end product. That's what we do with the code. And the end product and the satisfaction levels are something amazing.
The way to get best out of a person is by providing him or her the opportunity and completely trusting the person that he will take it through. Nobody wants to be an option. The belief you place in the person is what makes them do their best. And that's what we do at Sahaj.
I have been able to, or not just me, a lot of other folks have been able to build a tribe here. And each tribe has its own conviction, has its own beliefs, has its own rituals, which is what is fascinating about that. At the time of hiring, you don't call it hiring, you try to increase the size of your tribe. Second is when you onboard a person or when a person joins you or become part of Sahaj, you let them try to bring in new aspects, new views, new thoughts, new processes. And third one is letting people do their mistakes. By doing mistakes, people do their best.
Today, we are at a place where we are actually creating a new segment in the market. It's all about our positioning, where we are positioned as one of the premium IT players, which operate in pretty much a very high value segment. We provide a lot of value to our client, and also from a cost perspective, we are a very premium player.
We believe Sahaj in the next few years is going to redefine the way IT services are being provided. We believe we are going to be one of the most premium IT global solutions company across the entire world.